The club completely fell apart. It all smelled terribly, and in my heart, I knew we were going down the wrong path.
Different player, same story.
We've finally been able to reveal the truth about the nonsense we were forced into.
Former Crows key forward Josh Jenkins this afternoon echoing AFL legend Eddie Betts's bombshell claims about a 2018 training camp.
It was brainwashing. When you look back on it, it's kind of think, what the hell were you doing?
Frankly, some of the stuff that went on was a disgrace.
Following their 2017 grand final loss to Richmond, the Crows employed performance consultants to address the premiership drubbing through mindset training.
They wanted to up the game. They wanted to make us mentally strong. They wanted to make us resilient and a lot tougher in our mind.
But Betts's new book alleges the camp subjected players to a vicious initiation, including vows of silence, a ban from showering, corrupting Aboriginal rituals, and being blindfolded on a bus while the Richmond song blared.
How can you describe some of those allegations, or revelations, they're not allegations, as not perfect? They're horrifying.
But the most gutting allegation, while players held a harnessed Betts back from reaching a knife to free himself, instructors hurled targeted abuse derived from a compulsory private counselling session.
When my turn on the harness arrived, I was fighting against three or four teammates who would then let go of the rope so I would fall to the ground.
Betts wrote the deeply personal barb centred around his upbringing, his mum, and his ability as a father.
I was hurting and I was having this pain and feeling sick.
And when he complained to the club, the three-time All-Australian was dropped from the Crows leadership group weeks later.
Every time the camp was brought up, it felt like the place was crumbling in.
The club and performance consultants were cleared of any wrongdoing by the AFL Integrity Unit and Safe Work South Australia. Crows officials insisting things have changed.
We all love Eddie, and hopefully Eddie's getting over that. That was 4 years ago. Certainly the club's moved on from that and have made a lot of ground since back then.
But Jenkins claims a player welfare report commissioned in the wake of the camp was never acted on.
Our doctor expressing in front of the entire playing group and most of the staff that what had occurred on the camp was, in his medical opinion, unacceptable.
And more than seven former players are now considering joining a class action against the club as the controversy continues.
We didn't need to bring people, outside people, to come in to make us mentally tough, and we were already a great environment and a team that really cared for one another.
Now, we reached out to the Adelaide Crows and the performance consultants for comment. We're yet to hear back. So Adelaide lawyer Greg Griffin joins us now. Greg, you're working on a class action lawsuit over details from this camp. Just how many players are you in talks with, and what have they said?
Well, you need a minimum of seven players to bring proceedings in the Victorian Supreme Court. I would have thought we're well over double that number within 48 hours.
Wow.
So I don't think there's any problem with the numbers coming on board, and what we're talking about is what remedies are available to them through the court process.
And what may those remedies be? Because this suit has been in the works for 3 years. You say that so many more players have now come forward. So what happens next?
Well, I've actually been working on this for over 3.5 years. It's just that there's been this great period of silence whilst both the Crows and the AFL relied upon the so-called AFL investigation, which back in 2020 in the Herald Sun I said was just nonsense and an example of a schoolboy marking his own homework and giving himself an A+, and then the Safe Work report, which was supposed to have cleared everything, when in fact those reports I don't think are worth a crushed carnation. And now Eddie, of course, released his book, and that has been the catalyst for, quite frankly, an outburst of relief from players who now feel that they're finally going to get heard and not just be the subject of what I would describe as whitewashed reports.
Greg, this afternoon it's come to light that the Crows club doctor allegedly filed a welfare report after the camp and that wasn't acted on. How significant is this?
Well, that's very significant. I knew that Josh was going to make that announcement today, and it was a very brave thing for both Josh and the doctor to actually come forward, because it is incredibly important, and I suspect that there's much more to come beyond that. This is not the only document that will be damning in terms of the conduct of the camp and the effect it had on the players. I think you'll find that there will be a plethora of very damaging documents that once out in the general public will actually show what happened.
Greg, despite Gil McLaughlin's apology, the AFL maintains that no laws or rules were broken. Given these allegations, does that seem possible?
No, it's impossible. I mean, I think Gil ought to sit down and read the player's contract and see the obligation that the AFL and the Crows have in terms of their obligations to the players. It's a breach of contract claim, it's a tortious claim, and the statements made by Gil, which I thought were appropriate and brave, really set the scene for how this is going to go forward. Because he was right. I mean, what happened on that camp was unacceptable, and the players are entitled now to have the truth come out.
Greg, thank you very much for joining us.
Pleasure.